Welcome to Alpha as Gas, where we look at betas, alphas, demos, and early access games. Today's game is Phasmophobia, a co-op ghost-hunting psychological horror game where you and up to three friends set out to various locations to have encounters with the paranormal. Don't worry though, it's not as confusing as it sounds. The goal of the game, as mentioned, is to seek out ghosts and all manner of other plane beings. You don't necessarily need to catch them, more so document as much as you can to earn some cash, which can be used for more equipment for future adventures. It's an interesting concept that takes the idea of both horror and ghost hunting and makes for a fun ride. There's many different scenarios you can tackle, ranging from a house in suburbia that's just become haunted, to a cabin in the woods, to even larger areas like an abandoned high school. You can also encounter several different kinds of paranormal beings, such as spirits, poltergeists, phantoms, and so much more. However, to interact with such beings, you'll need ghost hunting tools such as flashlights, UV torches, digital thermometers, salt, crosses, cameras, EMF readers, spirit boxes, and various other items, using the right combination of items to draw out the appropriate specter. Of course, since you can only hold three items, four if you play in VR, it means you and your teammates will have to be making trips back to the van, leaving someone alone in the room with whatever spiritual force you've encountered. On top of using tools, however, you can also communicate with these beings by using your PC microphone, asking them questions like, who are they? How do they die? What do they want? Ask them to give you a sign, or even threatening them with bad words, all in an effort to draw them out. While the game doesn't have any combat, it does have objectives that you can do to earn extra cash, so sometimes leaving someone alone in a room with them is the best way to get some results to complete said objectives. This is one of those creepy games I totally vibe with. The atmosphere of each area, the different types of ghoulies you can encounter mixed with the feelings of suspense, fear, discomfort, and excitement make for an amazing spoopy experience that's just perfect for this time of year. Whenever I play this game and someone had to stay with the ghost, I would love to volunteer to be that person. On one hand, if I was streaming, I'd want the stream to experience it with me, but I also wanted to experience what it's like to be trapped in a room with a being no longer of this world. I know some people find it terrifying, but I love this kind of spooky stuff, so it just made things all the more entertaining for me. And I'm not even playing in VR. Of course, with this being an early access game, there are some quirks that need to be ironed out. For starters, while this game isn't a graphical marvel, it is optimized pretty poorly. I have a pretty beefy PC, but even I had to lower the settings whenever I streamed the game as it was causing me to drop frames. A key factor of the game is being able to communicate with your fellow players and ghosts over push-to-talk chat, however this would break all the time, to the point where whenever I played with people we just used Discord chat unless we were communicating with a spirit. Other issues are such things as only being able to adjust game settings or even see the controls before you enter a room online. Many times when I started the game early on, I had no idea what the controls were, and the only way to check was to back out of the game session completely. A lot of options aren't even available outside matches within a session, something that should be easy to implement. Like I said, this game is in early access, so there's plenty of time to fix these issues. Despite its flaws, Phasmophobia is an incredible horror experience and a game worth playing even in its current form. That being said, I am mixed on the $15 price point. While not a steep price, it is a little high in my opinion for a game in early access. If this was a full game, that price point would be a pretty dang good deal, but the game is still very rough around the edges, so it's hard to recommend you spend that much. However, it does have plenty of content to keep you busy, and if you're a horror junkie or a ghost hunting fan, this one is definitely worth experiencing. If you scare easily and those things creep you out, best to stay clear unless you have some brave friends to play with. In any case, this has been another Alpha As for River City Gamers. We'll see you on the next one.